Very good evening to all of you. Today we are going to discuss some few practical aspects about medical termination of pregnancy. I am not going to go into the details of how MTP is done, but the basic documentation and basic consent forms and all those things which you keep in our department, and as a PG or as a practitioner, what all things are required to be followed, right? So I am going to share the screen, right? So in this screen, we will see the government guidelines which are given, and they are given very well on FOCSI website. And these guidelines are, it's a kind of act, like, PCP NDT Act and MTP Act. All these acts were made to make the abortions legal, right? Now, why we felt that there is a need of making abortion legal? The most important motivation for that, number one, was preventing unwanted pregnancies. So basically to reduce the population, and secondly to make abortions quite safe, right? Because the women were going to quacks and they were having illegal abortions, and many women used to go into septicemia and die of septic shock or septic abortions. So I'll just share the screen where, government has given beautiful guidelines on what is an MTP Act, right? So this is how the document goes. This is a document which is available on FOCSI website. If you go on a FOCSI website, you will see that it's given by National Health Mission, and it ensuring access to safe abortion and addressing gender-biased selection. So in this, it's a kind of, booklet. But then what all points we as practitioners should remember, I'll just quickly go through them. As they have said, India has seen significant decline in maternal mortality and is on the, please mute yourself. Yeah. Right. And it is on the track to achieve the targets set under the Millennium Development Goals. While there is encouraging progress in the overall numbers of sex ratio at birth and child sex ratio, as well as the contribution of unsafe abortions to maternal deaths, the unsafe abortions and maternal deaths are still continuing. So there's a lot of responsibility on us as obstetricians and gynecologists to see to it that every abortion is safe. And even for the administrative authorities, for the health administrative authorities in India, in district level or at even state level, it becomes very important. So what should we know about MTP? So MTP Act was made in 1971, as we call it as MTP termination or medical termination of pregnancy act in 71. Then it was amended periodically depending upon the, what all practical problems were found. And then we came with another act, that was Prenatal Diagnostic Techniques Act in 1994. And now this act also got amended in 2001. And now in recently we've had some amendments regarding the period of gestation, which has been increased also now to up to 24 weeks under which we can do MTP. So just quickly, let's go through what are the main points in MTP Act, right? So I wanted to show you this document. Understanding the MTP Act and its implementation. Always remember, as we were taught in our PSM, class, that whenever you read about MTP Act, it has three P's, like three P's of labor. One is the person who can do it, the place where it can be done, and the third thing. So the first one was the conditions under which. So who can terminate becomes the person. Then the place where it can be terminated, and P is the policies under which it can be done. This is how we used to remember, right? Now, number one here is conditions under which a pregnancy may be terminated. This is what you have in your form one, which we fill in the consent form. The consent form which is filled, or the consent form is form C, which is filled by the patient, and patient's consent is there. Form one is the information which a doctor, which I am giving to the civil authorities regarding that MTP process. And in that you have these conditions mentioned under which the MTP can be done. And you all know those conditions. You just can't do MTP just because patient wants it. You know, a couple comes to you and just tells you that, you know, we don't want this child, and you just terminate it. Every effort should be made to continue the pregnancy. Just because they want MTP, you will do it. It's not going to serve any purpose. So there should be a valid reason for terminating a life, right? Every fetus also has a right to live. So there has to be a valid reason. One of the most common valid reason which a woman can say that, you know, we were using some kind of contraceptive, but it has not worked well, and now we don't want the pregnancy. This is the easiest reason which you can quote for any MTP, and that makes the law very light, or very, you know, it can be used by any, you can do it legally for anybody. And this is how the population also can be controlled on a larger level, right? So one is continuation of pregnancy would involve the risk to the life of pregnant woman, or it may cause grave injury to her physical and mental health. In under this, it will be like, you know, she's already having severe anemia, she's already having hyperemesis with ketoacidosis, she has been admitted, or she is uncontrolled diabetes, like that, all those things. And then heart disease, severe, New York Heart Association, grade 3, grade 4, and now she's pregnant. So all these things will come under this. Mental health, she is a minor girl. Again, there is another rule also because she's minor, but at the same time, mental health will also be affected. Or she is, already having one child. Though the family wants it, she is not mentally prepared to continue that pregnancy, could be another cause. Then substantial risk that the child, if born, would be seriously handicapped due to physical and mental abnormalities. Pregnancy is caused by rape, and pregnancy is caused due to the failure of contraceptive, or married, caused due to failure of contraceptive. This is the easiest cause which you can tick in that form one. Now, place where it can be terminated, hospital established or maintained by the government, or a place approved by the government or district level committee, headed by the chief medical officer or district health officer. So if you have, our hospital is already approved by the district authorities. So if you open your nursing home as a new MTP center, you want to develop that, then you will have to apply to the district health officer and get your center approved. Just because you are a gynecologist or obstetrician doesn't mean you can start doing MTP in your nursing home. You are an authorized person, but your center needs to be approved. For that, you need to get it approved from the district health authorities. So there are two categories. They decide whether your center can do MTP. One is below 12 weeks and another is above 12 weeks. So as per the national guidelines, pregnancy may be terminated at government facilities up to 8 weeks at primary health center, because most of the time you're going to give them medical drugs. 12 weeks of gestation at community health center, 20 weeks of gestation at district health hospital. We being a tertiary health care center, we can do any of these at our center. The DLC may approve a private place to conduct terminations up to 12 weeks and up to 20 weeks. Now, when they give it up to 12 weeks, the criteria are different. And when they give at up to 20 weeks, the criteria are different. We all know that 16 weeks, 18 weeks, the complications, as the pregnancy increases, termination becomes more complicated. Just imagine a woman is 5 weeks pregnant, you give her mifepristone and misoprostol. It is just going to simulate, or it is, the bleeding is going to be just like menstrual bleeding. And the bleeding is not going to cause much problem, right? As the pregnancy advances, the placenta has increased, the products of conception have become larger, and so the bleeding is going to be more, the process is going to be painful at times. It may not even completely happen. It may have ruptures. All those problems can occur, right? In that case, after 12 weeks, they have kept certain clause that the center needs to have blood transfusion facilities, OT facility, anesthetist, all those things. So 12 weeks and 20 weeks have different criteria for a center to get approved. So you have to display in your nursing home or in your OPD that, you know, your center is either approved for up to 12 weeks or up to 20 weeks. And for that, the DHO authorities will come and inspect your nursing home or your hospital, which we already have in our hospital. And this certificate needs to be periodically renewed. They will come and periodically renew the certificate. Now, who can terminate the pregnancy? Fortunately, we all are postgraduate. We have done our post-graduation. So you all are going to be eligible to do MTPs. But even there are certain practitioners who with experience, who with training can do. Why they have made this facility? Because they want more and more rural people to get access, which is, you know, from good trained health workers. They need not wait for, you know, going to cities and get the MTPs done, right? So they want people, girls, not to go to these quacks and land up into septic abortions. So in the case of, so it is any MD or DGO or, you know, a 6-month trained OBGY person can do MTPs. In case of a medical practitioner who was registered in state medical register immediately before the commencement of act with experience in practice of OBGY for a period of not less than 3 years. So most of us are coming in this category. Then in case of medical practitioner who was registered in state medical register after the commencement, kindly mute yourself. So has experience in any hospital for a period of not less than 1 year, right? So all these things have been told. Like, you know, you may say that, are ye to practitioner hai, ye kaise MTP kar raha hai. But there are facilities which are available at government where a general practitioner can work in a district health hospital, do certain amount of MTPs under train and get trained under a gynecologist, and then they approve him of, you know, they give him a certificate and that person is approved to give these services. So only obstetrician gynecologist may not be the person who can give. There are people who are trained for 6 months or certain number of procedures also they have given. Ki aapne agar itne procedures kiye hain itne duration mein, then you are eligible to provide these services. So as I said, the policy under which, the person and the place. So these three things are decided by the law. It's an act, MTP Act. So these three things need to be there before you move ahead and go and perform MTP. So how do you decide? Are in these three P's, are we fitting into these three P's? Yes, because we all are obstetricians and gynecologists in our hospital. Is our hospital place authorized? Yes, our hospital is authorized. If you come to my chamber, you will see that certificate which is given by the government that our hospital is authorized. Then third thing is under which conditions? That we decide depending upon each and every patient, she fits into which category. But you just cannot write that patient wants MTP and you did MTP. So there has to be a valid reason. So when the patient comes to you, patient is willing for MTP, please don't write that, because you never advise MTP to a patient. Even if you know, say you have done screening and there is a Down's risk, say 1 in 50, then you are just supposed to tell the couple that, you know, this is the risk you have, and you may have the risk of having a congenital anomaly in the fetus. But never write on paper advice MTP unless it is really required for the, you know, the patient is dying or something like that. Then only in that emergent situation you will advise. But otherwise, most of the time the decision is taken by the couple. So you are going to write that patient wants MTP, or in a situation where medical emergency is there, you are going to write on the paper that such and such condition of the mother or such and such condition of the fetus is not safe or is not salvageable. The fetus is not salvageable or not fit for survival, or the mother will have, the mortality risk is very high. So this has been explained to the couple, explain if the mother is unconscious to the relatives and they have opted for MTP, right? Never ever write on paper that you have advised MTP. And once they have accepted or they have chosen it as a mode of this thing management, then just mention on paper that they have opted for MTP. Now, the whole purpose of telling you all these things today is you should understand every time when you are doing documentation. The most important thing is documentation in MTP. So at your level, at JR1 level, you are not supposed to take, you just observe and assist what your seniors are saying. Learn all the documentation part. Learn what all things are required for any MTP to be performed. So three P's, as I said, the person, the place, and the policies under which you can do. The person, as we know, all of us, place, our hospital is already approved, and it is approved till 20 weeks, and now with the amendment of act, up to 24 weeks. Then policies, we all know contraception failure, health hazard to the mother's health, hazard to the fetus health, and you know, life-saving in cases of any emergent maternal conditions. Now, other important things which I wanted to tell you is these forms. Now, what is form A, form B, form F, form C? These are all forms which are there for approval of our centers. So form B is the certificate of approval for a private place issued by the district health officers, right? So this is the approval which the district health hospital or district authorities give it to us. Now, as far as record keeping is concerned, specifically all JR1s and JR2s, please understand there is something called as form 1, there is something called as form 2, and there is something called as form C. So I'll share the screen now. Let me just go through these forms, right? Now see, this is the form C. You all can see this. Now this is the form which you fill for the as a consent form of the patient, right? So here she gives a consent that I am so and so and so many years of this thing, and this is the form C is nothing but the consent which the patient gives. So here you have only the consent of patient. So this is form C. For our convenience in our hospital, on the back side of this form, we have something called as form 1. Form 1 and form C are two separate documents, but to keep the record in a, you know, in one compact way, we have kept it one behind the other, right? So form 1 is now the information which I am as a gynecologist providing to the district authorities regarding this MTP. So here, what information we are giving? What is my name? What are my details? Then second thing is, under which clause I decided that MTP would be good for this patient. So these all things are given. So here, what all things are, please mute yourself. So my name will come, the person who is going to do it, name and qualification and address. Now twice it has been given here. Can you see? Now I do require it twice. So if the MTP is done within 10 to 12 weeks, now it has been 10 weeks, then it is only the single person can decide and take decision to make, to go ahead with MTP. So only one in my unit, say if I'm deciding everything, then maybe only my name will be there. But say she is 18 weeks pregnant now, and now the gestation has gone beyond 12 weeks. And now you decided to do MTP because it was a highly anomalous baby, and now she has opted for MTP, and you're going to do. So now the question is not that even if I can do it completely on my own alone, legally, two gynecologists or two persons who are eligible to do MTP are supposed to discuss and take decision and mention here and give the report to the government. So this twice it has been given only for such cases. So you for less than 12 weeks, don't write the name twice. If it is less than 10 to 12 weeks, only one person's name, one person's address will be there. This will all go blank. But if it is more than 12 weeks, you're going to put two names, their qualifications, and then the signature of two people should be there. Right? I hope this is very clear about form 1. And form C is for the consent of patient. Usi ke piche we have form 1, which is to be filled by the person or the gynecologist who is, or a trained person who is going to perform or prescribe the drugs. Then comes form 2. Now this form 2 and form 3 are the records which the office keeps or the hospital that hospital keeps. That means in our hospital, this record is given by Kanchan, our clerk, to the our CMS, and through our CMS it goes to the district health authorities. Just see this form 2, right? So form 1, which we felt for every MTP, form 1, form C is the consent form filled by the patient, individual patient. Form 1 is filled for individual patient by one or two practitioners depending upon the gestational age. Form 2 is filled by the office clerk, and that means we only, but then it is an official record of the number of the MTPs done per month, and it goes to district health authorities. So as you can see, they have mentioned ki 12, up to 12 weeks how many were there, up to 12 to 20 weeks how many were there, what was the religion of the patient, what was the term. So this is all the statistical record which the government keeps for every MTP, and this record should go every month, right? Now coming to form 3. Form 3 is nothing but the big register which is kept in our cupboard, and it's a confidential register where we keep a record of every MTP which we do, and that record of every patient needs to be kept for 5 years. After 5 years, even if you lose the record, it is not that, you know, some legal action will be taken. So the government says that for a single MTP which you have done, her record should be available in the hospital for the next 5 years. So form 2 and 3 are maintained by the hospital. So when you have your own nursing homes, you will have to maintain form 3 in your cupboards. Form 2 will go monthly to the hospital authorities, and form C and 1 are for individual patient. And form C and 1 are to be filled before you prescribe any drug to the patient, because it's a consent of both. Form C is for the patient, and form 1 is by me or by the gynecologist. So unless you have filled form 1 and form C, never ever prescribe any drug, never ever start any procedure, because you have not taken consent, you cannot start, right? And it has to be submitted to the hospital authorities within 3 hours of the procedure you have started. That means what? You gave misoprostol, mifepristone to the patient at 4 o'clock in the evening. The form should reach within 3 hours. That is what they have written. So in the morning, if you have 9 o'clock, you have prescribed medical store has a prescription, and on that there is a time of 9 o'clock in the morning you had given, and this form does not reach by 5 p.m. And if there is an inspection by authorities in the hospital and you don't have all these records, your center may be closed, it may be sealed, the entire registration may be lost. So it's a very important message to all of you that before filling form C and form 1, you are not supposed to start any prescription, any procedure, any installations, police insertions, all those things should not be done. So this, if you want, you should keep ideally in labor room, wherever you are going to do this, in an OPD, in ward, and in labor room. Or it should be available in soft copy in your computers. And before you do this, please don't start. Just because patient came at 4 o'clock, don't start in hurry and give her medications. Never do that, because you will be in trouble. Your hospital registration may get cancelled, and the whole process can become illegal, and we all can go to, you know, there can be, because it's an act and it will be a criminal thing if you have not followed the laws and rules. So be very vigilant, be very careful. Even if, you know, somebody is telling you to start medications, don't do that. So first take signatures and then only go ahead with. So if any patient comes to you for MTP in OPD, the first thing which you do before even sending the blood samples is, after every decision has been made, keep the consent forms with you. And once the green signal after investigations and all those things come, then only please go ahead with your actual prescriptions, actual procedures. Second thing is the form C and filled form C with signatures, and form 1, they are closed in an envelope. then they are put inside the envelope, and that envelope has to be given, that patient has to be given a reference number, and this reference number is by which you are going to address that case, because it's a very confidential document. You cannot just call, this patient can, you can't put the name of the patient on that envelope and give it to the hospital authorities like that. So all those records are kept confidential in an envelope format, and then there is a numbering which is given to each and every case. That same number is mentioned in your form 3. Form 3 is where you keep the register in your cupboard. Form 2 is monthly form which goes to the hospital authorities. So only 4 forms you have to remember. Form C, which is signed by the patient. Usi ke piche form 1 in our hospital, which are signed by the doctors who are doing it. Then in office, department office, there is a form 2 and there is a form 3. In your nursing home also, form 3 is nothing but the register which you maintain for 5 years for every patient, the record of all patients, and then in that register you will have that same reference number which you put on the envelope, right? And then form 2 will go every month from you to the hospital authorities at your district level. So all these things are very important whenever you are doing any case of MTP. So I hope I'm very clear to you why I always insist that without all these consent forms, you're not supposed to start MTP. There is no hurry at all. Don't send any prescription anywhere before you have taken these signatures. Another situation which I'll tell you is giving medical method of termination. So you gave all those consent forms, everything is ready with you. Now in medical method of termination, what happens? The patient may take tablet or may not take tablet when she goes home. The most important thing for OPD patients, where you are doing it before 7 weeks on OPD basis, make sure that all those tablets which you are giving, mifepristone, then after 48 or 24 hours, misoprostol, they are given in front of you. The process itself is like that you are supposed to give after the patient is fit for MTP. You have filled the consent forms, form 1 and then form C. You are supposed to give the tablet, first tablet, in front of you in the morning hours. And then the next 48 hours or 24 hours later, when you give misoprostol, it has to be again given in front of you in the OPD itself. And then make her wait for preferably for 4 to 5 hours, because the major amount of bleeding which starts, it happens within 2 to 3 hours after the misoprostol. And then if the bleeding is not much, after 6 hours of waiting in the hospital, she can again go back. You need not admit her. After 7 weeks, the same schedule is followed, MIFI and miso. But then why are you admitting her? Because the products have increased, the placenta size has increased, now the bleeding will increase. So that is how you keep her in the hospital. Not because, just 7 weeks mein kyun nahi kar rahe, 9 weeks mein kyun admit kar rahe. So understand that now the bleeding is going to be more, at home she can have giddiness, she can faint, all those problems can occur. So the medical method of termination of pregnancy can be used up to 20 weeks. That is not a problem, but till to 7 weeks, they have allowed 49 days. They have allowed on OPD basis only because the products are so small that it will simulate menstrual bleeding, right? So that is how these things are decided to how to do it on OPD basis or on this thing. Another record which you should keep for any MTP is the sonography record, because that is a proof that you have done it at what particular gestation. And then you should keep the fitness record, that means whether her hemoglobin was good or not, her blood group Rh positive or negative, because antibody needs to be given. All these records, if you keep in your nursing home, it is going to be a very good practice. But otherwise, legally, you are supposed to keep form 1, form C, sonography as far as possible, keep the record, because that will be a proof that you have done it within whatever gestation you have done. Beyond 12 weeks, must take signature of 2 gynecologists. More than signature, 2 gynecologists should opine on such a case, because it is a complicated procedure. Now the risk is more, and that is how it is always 2 signatures are required, 2 names are required. When it is less than 12 weeks, only 1 person's name and 1 person's signature will be there. So I think I was very clear about it, and I hope you will follow all the rules now and will do it with understanding that why it is important to keep all these records very well. Thank you so much.